Before it became illegal, triple talaq or talaq-e-biddat was a practice under which a Muslim man could divorce his wife by simply uttering talaq three times. This was allowed by Hanafi Islamic school of law. However, triple talaq as a mode of divorce was not universal among Muslims across the world, as many other Islamic schools of thought prefer the divorce process to be deferred, in many cases over a period of 3 months. Islamic scholars say the Quran spells out how to issue a divorce. It has to be spread over 3 months, which allows a couple time for reflection and reconciliation. But for centuries, the controversial instant triple talaq, known as talaq-e-biddat, has been practiced in India with approval from the clergy. Biddat is the Persian word for sin. Campaigners against the practice say that modern technology has made it even easier for unscrupulous men to dump their wives by phone, email or text. There were instances of men using Skype, WhatsApp or Facebook for the purpose. Instantaneous triple talaq finds no mention in Sharia or the Quran and is banned in 22 Islamic countries, including Pakistan and Bangladesh. Over the years, many Muslim women have challenged triple talaq in courts.
अब मुस्लिम महिलाओं को डर के मां जो उनके ऊपर हमेशा एक तलवार घूम रही थी, रोटी जल जाएगी तलाक मिल जाएगा, देर से सो उठोगी तलाक मिल जाएगा, नहाने में देर हो गई तलाक मिल जाएगा, कोई दूसरी बीवी पसंद आ गई तो तलाक दे दिया, तो ये जो हरसमेंट था, ये जो क्रुएलिटी थी, ये जो इंसानियत के खिलाफ जो एक व्यवहार हो रहा था, वो मुझे लगता है अब ख़त्म होगा। क्योंकि यदि आपने अब टेलीफोन से कैसे भी अगर आपने ट्रिपल तलाक दिया, सीधे जेल, नो बेल, 3 साल तक अंदर। अगर पत्नी चाहेगी मजिस्ट्रेट सामने तब आपको बेल मिलेगी। अगर आपने कह दिया कि हाँ भाई हमसे गलती होगी, गलती मान लिया और पत्नी ने कह दिया ठीक है इनको माफ़ी देते हैं, अब सारी की सारी जो बागडोर है वो महिला के हाथ में आ गई है। अब मुस्लिम बहनें चाहेंगी तो पति को बेल मिलेगी, नहीं तो जेल रहेंगे। तो मुझे लगता है इससे बहुत बड़ा फ़ायदा होने वाला है।
आफ्टर थर्ड तलाक वॉज प्रोनाउंस्ड, अ वुमन वॉज सपोज टू मैरी अनदर मैन, consummate the relationship, and only after following the original procedure of talaq-e-sunnah, which is divorce as per the Prophet's sayings and Quranic dictation, was she be able to marry the former husband again. This practice was the nikah halala. Women have often described it as a barbaric practice, and there are demands to abolish this practice. There are broadly two methods under which a wife can claim divorce in Muslims. One is talaq-e-tafweez and the other is talaq-e-khula. Under tafweez, the husband may delegate his power to give talaq to his wife or any third party. This right has to be in the form of a contract with conditions, like if a man marries again, then there can be a divorce. The other one is khula. This is a divorce which is at the request of the wife. In this case, the woman has to make an offer of divorce to the man. The man must accept the offer with consideration, which often means the woman has to give back the mehr taken during the marriage. 51 years ago, on April 18, 1996, a protest was held against triple talaq and polygamy. It was led by Muslim progressive thinker Hamid Dalwai and saw the participation of 7 women, including his wife Mehrunisa Dalwai. The women submitted a memorandum to then Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Vasantrao Nayak, demanding justice for Muslim women, a ban on polygamy and execution of a common civil code. Dalwai and his wife Mehrunisa was ostracized by the community and dubbed enemies of the religion for organizing meetings and agitations demanding that Muslim women should not be discriminated against in the name of religious law. Over the years, the protest gathered pace with more people joining in. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.